Hey there, space enthusiasts and cosmic curiosity seekers. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to harness the power of an entire star? Well, buckle up, because we're about to dive into the mind-bending world of Dyson Spheres. And trust me, things are about to get wild. Imagine an alien civilization so advanced they've built a gigantic structure that completely engulfs their star, capturing almost all of its energy. Sounds like something straight out of a sci-fi blockbuster, right? Back in 1960, a brilliant physicist named Freeman Dyson proposed this cosmic megastructure idea. Since then, it's been the stuff of both scientific inquiry and late-night sci-fi binges. But what if I told you that we might be on the verge of finding actual evidence of these colossal constructions? That's right, we're talking about potential alien technology on a scale that makes our most impressive feats look like sandcastles. Now, before you start packing your bags for an interstellar road trip, let's break down what's got the astronomy world buzzing. A team of sky-watching sleuths has identified not one, not two, but seven stars within our cosmic neighborhood. Well, within 1,000 light-years, which is practically next door in space terms, that are behaving very, very strangely. These aren't just any stars, they're M-dwarfs, the cosmic equivalent of fun-sized candy bars. They're glowing with an infrared intensity that's just unheard of by our geniuses. But wait, there's more. As if seven wasn't exciting enough, another group of stellar detectives has added 53 more stars to our that's weird list. We're talking about a total of 60 stars that are lighting up the infrared spectrum like cosmic Christmas trees. And get this, these stars range from little red dwarfs all the way up to stars that could be twins of our sun, scattered across a distance of up to 6,500 light-years. Now you might be thinking, sure, but what's the big deal about some extra infrared glow? Well, my curious friend, that glow could be the smoking gun we've been searching for in our quest to find advanced alien civilizations. You see, if a Dyson Sphere were capturing a star's energy, it would give off waste heat, and that heat would show up as, you guessed it, infrared radiation. Of course, the scientific community isn't breaking out the alien welcome banners just yet. These infrared anomalies could have other explanations, like cosmic dust bunnies or other astrophysical phenomena we're still trying to understand. But that's what makes this so exciting. We're standing on the precipice of potentially groundbreaking discoveries, peering into the unknown and asking questions that could reshape our understanding of the universe and our place in it. Let's start with our Magnificent Seven. A group of M-dwarf stars that are practically in our cosmic backyard, just a stone's throw away at 1,000 light-years. Now, M-dwarfs are like the chihuahuas of the stellar world, small, abundant, and often overlooked. But these seven? They're strutting their stuff on the infrared catwalk, glowing with an intensity that's making astronomers do a double take. Imagine you're at a party and suddenly seven people start glowing like they've swallowed light bulbs. That's essentially what's happening here, but on a cosmic scale. These stars are emitting infrared radiation in a way that screams, "Hey, look at me! Something weird's going on here!" It's like they're wearing "I might be surrounded by alien megastructure" t-shirts. But hold on to your space helmets, because our cosmic party doesn't stop at seven guests. Oh no, we've got a full-blown galactic shindig going on. Another group of stellar sleuths has crashed the party with 53 more stars, bringing our total to a whopping 60 potential Dyson Sphere candidates. It's like finding not just one needle in a haystack, but an entire sewing kit. These additional stars aren't just carbon copies of our original seven. We're talking about a diverse stellar lineup ranging from red dwarfs to sun-like stars. It's like a cosmic buffet of potential alien engineering projects. And get this, they're scattered across a distance of up to 6,500 light-years. That's not just in our neighborhood. It's like finding suspicious activity all over the cosmic city. Now, you might be wondering, how did we even find these stellar oddballs? Well, it's all thanks to some seriously impressive astronomical detective work. Scientists have been scouring the skies, analyzing data from various telescopes, looking for that telltale infrared glow. It's like looking for a very specific kind of firefly in a galaxy-sized forest at night. The discovery of these 60 stars is a game changer. It's not just a fluke or a one-off observation. We're talking about a pattern here, folks. A pattern that suggests something systematic might be going on. Whether it's Dyson spheres or some yet unknown natural phenomena, one thing's for sure, these stars are begging for our attention. And here's the kicker. Each of these stars could be hosting its own potential alien megastructure. That's 60 possible advanced civilizations, 60 potential cosmic engineering marvels, 60 chances to answer that age-old question, are we alone in the universe? So what's next up for our stellar suspects? Well, they're about to face the astronomical equivalent of a police lineup. Scientists are gearing up to study these stars in unprecedented detail. We're talking spectroscopic analysis, long-term monitoring, and maybe even some good old-fashioned stakeouts. Okay, maybe not that last one, but you get the idea. Ready to dive deeper? Let's explore infrared radiation, specifically Dyson spheres and enigmatic phenomena causing elevated readings. Imagine you're at a rock concert, but instead of seeing the band, you're feeling the heat radiating from the stage. That's essentially what we're dealing with here, but on a cosmic scale. These stars we've identified are putting on one heck of a thermal show, and we've got front row seats. So why are we so hot and bothered about infrared? Well, if you're an alien civilization with a Dyson sphere, you're basically wearing a giant cosmic sweater around your star. And like any good sweater, it's going to trap some heat. That excess heat has to go somewhere, and in the vacuum of space, it radiates out as infrared energy. It's like your star is running a cosmic fever, and we're the galactic thermometers. Now, let's break it down. Stars naturally emit infrared radiation. It's part of their electromagnetic repertoire. But these 60 stars we've identified, they're like the Beyoncés of the infrared world. They're outshining their peers in a way that's making astronomers sit up and take notice. It's not just a little extra glow. We're talking about significant excess emissions that can't be easily explained by natural stellar processes. You know what else is beaming with infrared hotness? Your ideas. Let us know in the comments section down below what you think about today's episode. What makes this infrared excess so tantalizing is its consistency across different types of stars. We're seeing similar patterns in small M dwarfs and larger sun-like stars. It's like finding the same unexplained heat signature in both a studio apartment and a mansion. It suggests something systematic rather than random chance. But here's where it gets really interesting. The specific pattern of this infrared excess is crucial. A Dyson sphere wouldn't just make a star look brighter in the infrared, it would create a particular spectral signature. It's like a cosmic fingerprint, and these stars are leaving some pretty intriguing prints. Of course, we need to be careful not to jump to conclusions. The universe is a tricky place, full of phenomena that can mimic the signatures we're looking for. For instance, some stars are surrounded by dust clouds that can absorb and re-emit stellar energy as infrared radiation. It's like trying to determine if someone has a fever when they're standing next to a bonfire. Tricky, but not impossible. That's why scientists are now focusing on detailed spectroscopic studies of these stars. By breaking down the light into its component wavelengths, we can get a much clearer picture of what's really going on. It's like moving from a blurry snapshot to a high-definition video of these stellar suspects. So what's the bottom line? These infrared emissions are our cosmic smoke signals. They don't definitively prove the existence of Dyson spheres, but they certainly suggest that something unusual is happening around these stars. It's as if we stumbled upon a series of cosmic campfires, and now we're trying to figure out who lit them and why. All right, space sleuths. It's time to put on our cosmic detective hats and dive into the challenges we're facing in this interstellar whodunit. Anyone want to raise their hands first and take a guess? First things first, let's talk about our prime suspects. Those sneaky, hot, dusted, obscured galaxies, or as we like to call them in the biz, hot dogs. No, we're not talking about spicy sausages in space, though that would be an interesting discovery. These galaxies are wrapped in thick dust clouds that gobble up starlight and burp out infrared radiation. This can look suspiciously similar to our Dyson sphere signals. So, how do we separate the cosmic wheat from the intergalactic chaff? Enter spectroscopy, our high-tech magnifying glass. This nifty technique allows us to break down starlight into its component colors, giving us a detailed fingerprint of what's going on around these stars. It's like being able to read the ingredients list on a bottle of alien hot sauce. We can see exactly what's cooking in these interstellar kitchens. But here's the catch. Gathering this kind of detailed data takes time, patience, and some seriously powerful telescopes. We're talking about peering across vast cosmic distances, trying to spot the equivalent of a firefly's twinkle from the other side of the world. It's not exactly a walk in the park, unless that park is the size of a galaxy and filled with invisible obstacles. And let's not forget, the universe loves to throw curveballs. Just when we think we've got it all figured out, some new cosmic phenomenon pops up and sends us back to the drawing board. But fear not, fellow space enthusiasts. Our cosmic detectives aren't easily deterred. They're bringing out the big guns, or should I say the big scopes. We're talking about next-generation telescopes like the James Webb Space Telescope. This bad boy is like giving Sherlock Holmes a smartphone. It's a game-changer in our ability to scrutinize these stellar suspects. And let's not forget the power of teamwork. Astronomers around the world are joining forces, sharing data, and cross-checking findings. It's like assembling the Avengers of astrophysics, but instead of fighting Thanos, they're battling cosmic confusion. One of the most exciting aspects of this investigation is the long-term monitoring. We're not just taking a snapshot, we're making a whole cosmic movie. By watching these stars over extended periods, we can track changes in their behavior. Is that infrared glow consistent? Does it flicker or fade? It's like stalking out a suspect's house, but instead of a house, it's a star, and instead of days, it's years or even decades. But here's the million light-year question. What if we actually confirm a Dyson sphere? Talk about opening a can of cosmic worms, right? If that happens, we'd be faced with a whole new set of challenges. How do we communicate with a civilization capable of such feats? What are the implications of our understanding of physics, technology, and our place in the universe? It's enough to make your brain do backflips in your skull. Okay, folks. Now we're about to launch into the mind-bending implications of actually discovering a Dyson sphere. Imagine the day when we can confidently say, we found it. It would be like winning the cosmic lottery, but instead of cash, the prize is a complete paradigm shift in our understanding of, well, everything. First off, let's talk tech. If we confirm the existence of a Dyson sphere, we're essentially discovering a civilization that's mastered the art of stellar engineering. We're talking about a level of technological advancement that makes our most cutting-edge innovations look like stone tools. It's like comparing a smartphone to a carrier pigeon. That's the kind of leap we're dealing with here. Think about the energy implications. A civilization capable of building a Dyson sphere would have access to energy on a scale that's almost unfathomable to us. We're struggling to move away from fossil fuels, and these cosmic engineers are casually harnessing the power of an entire star. It's like comparing a AA battery to a nuclear power plant and then multiplying that difference by a billion. It's not just about the tech. Discovering a Dyson sphere would be the ultimate we-are-not-alone moment. For centuries, we've gazed at the stars, wondering if anyone else is out there. Finding a Dyson sphere would be like getting a cosmic billboard that says, "Hey Earthlings, guess what? The universe is teeming with life and some of it is way ahead of you." I wonder how these megalomaniacal leaders who believe they are the center of the universe will change when this happens. Now, let's consider the impact on science. Astronomy, physics, biology, engineering, virtually every scientific field would experience a seismic shift. We'd have proof of concepts that are currently theoretical, opening up new avenues of research and pushing the boundaries of what we consider possible. It would be like Newton seeing the apple fall, Einstein figuring out relativity, and the discovery of DNA all rolled into one epic moment of revelation. And let's not forget the philosophical and cultural implications. How would our religions, our politics, our very sense of identity change in the face of such a discovery? It would force us to reevaluate our place in the cosmos. Are we the cosmic equivalent of a remote tribe discovering that there's a whole world beyond our island? The existential questions alone could keep philosophers busy for centuries. The search for Dyson spheres can also spark a new era of space exploration and technological development. Imagine the boost in funding and public interest in space programs. We could see a new space race, not just between nations, but between Earth and the stars. It's like the whole planet would collectively say, "Challenge accepted," to our advanced cosmic neighbors. On the flip side, confirming the existence of Dyson spheres might also make us a bit nervous. If there are civilizations out there so far beyond us technologically, where do we fit in the cosmic pecking order? Are we the equivalent of cosmic ants, or do we have something unique to offer? It's a bit like finding out you're the new kid in a school where everyone else is light years ahead in their studies. Even if we don't find Dyson spheres, the search itself is invaluable. It's pushing our technology, our theories, and our imaginations to new limits. We're developing better telescopes, more sensitive instruments, and more sophisticated analysis techniques. In the process, we're uncovering new astrophysical phenomena and deepening our understanding of the universe. In the end, whether we find Dyson spheres or not, the journey is changing us. It's making us look up and out beyond our everyday concerns to ponder our place in this vast, mysterious universe. It's reminding us that we're all in this cosmic adventure together, united in our curiosity about what lies beyond our celestial horizon. So, keep dreaming big, keep asking questions, and keep your sense of wonder alive. Because in the search for Dyson spheres, we're not just looking for alien megastructures. We're exploring the very limits of what's possible. And who knows? Maybe someday, it'll be us building Dyson spheres around distant stars, waving hello to some other curious civilization just beginning to look up at the night sky and wonder, are we alone? Spoiler alert, the answer might just be a resounding, not even close. In conclusion, the hunt for Dyson spheres is more than just a scientific endeavor. It's a journey of discovery that touches on some of the most fundamental questions of our existence. So keep your eyes in the skies, your minds open to the possibilities, and your sense of wonder fully charged. Because in the vast cosmic ocean, we're just beginning to dip our toes in the water. Who knows what incredible discoveries await us in the depths? Remember, in the game of cosmic hide and seek, we may be it, but we're getting better at seeking every day. Stay curious, stay excited, and who knows, the next time you look up at the stars, you might just be gazing at the future set of humanity's very own Dyson sphere. That's the episode, everyone. Big thanks for tuning in. You know the ritual. Hit the like if you love the video. Click that notification bell. Subscribe. And until next time, stay insanely curious.